हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वंस अगेन आई वेलकम यू टू द क्लास ऑफ आवर जनरल इंग्लिश। इन दिस लेक्चर और इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट ऑफ इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज, दैट इज वीक फॉर्म्स एंड स्ट्रॉन्ग फॉर्म्स। एज फार एज आवर कम्युनिकेशन इन इंग्लिश इज कंसर्न और कॉन्वर्सेशन इंग्लिश इज कंसर्न, वी हैव टू कॉन्सेंट्रेट ऑन what are the weak forms and what are the strong forms of words or sentences or syllable which needs to give a peculiar attention by the speaker. So let us discuss first what is weak form. We'll start our discussion with concept called weak forms. In English, the words which do not stress are called as weakened, and therefore they are considered or they are called as weak forms. So remember, the words which do not receive stress are to be considered or as to be called as weak forms. Once again, I would like to repeat the definition of weak forms. So we have to focus on, we have to remember that weak forms refers to, or weak form means the words which do not receive stress. The words which are unstressed are called as weak forms. There are certain words in English, there are certain class of the word which we also call as grammatical function. They do not receive stress. They are only grammatical words. It means the words which do not receive stress, they are important as far as the construction of sentence is concerned. Syntactically, they are important. They will give a new meaning to the utterance, or they will change the meaning of the sentence. But when they are separated, when they stand alone, when they are separated from the connected speech or the sentence, in isolation, they do not have any meaning. As far as we were discussing the morphology, we talked about, it should have either semantic content or it should have either grammatical functions. The words which play grammatical function or grammatical role generally do not receive stress. Such words are called as weak forms. So which are these words? We have to keep in mind, we have to learn what are the weak forms, or which category of the words, or which class of the words comes under the category called weak forms. So the words which performs only grammatical functions are considered as articles. Remember, the words which only play grammatical function, they are also called as closed category of words. In our discussion of morphology, we talked about the closed category of the word and open category or open class of the word. So as far as the weak form is concerned, we have to keep in mind the words which only play grammatical function, they are important for understanding the meaning of the sentence. Syntactically, they are essential. Without absence of this grammatical element, or the words will affect the meaning of sentence. But these sentences, when these words come in isolation, when these words are separated from the sentence, it does not have, or they do not have any meaning. That is why such words or such category or the class of words, like, remember, articles, prepositions, conjunctions, then pronouns and auxiliary verbs. So this is called as grammatical function or closed class category of the word. So we have to keep in mind, in weak forms, auxiliary verbs, then articles, prepositions, conjunctions, nouns and others. So these words or these category or this class of the grammar, this class of the word is essential to make the sentence grammatically correct. But when they stand alone, they do not have any meaning of their own. These auxiliaries, articles, preposition, conjunction, pronouns and others like interjections, they are also called as a closed category of the word because no more addition is possible. We cannot add other words into this category. We cannot place other words into the category called articles, prepositions or conjunctions and pronouns. So there are certain auxiliary verbs like am, is, are, was, were, shall. So there are certain limitations. So no more addition is possible there. Then as far as the articles are concerned, we know that there are just three articles, a and the. But when they are used as a part of the whole sentence, it has a meaning. And when it is separated, when they are written in isolation, it does not have any meaning. For example, look at the sentence. I saw the tiger. So the is an article. So when it is placed in the sentence, it is meaningful. It makes some sense. It is essential to understand the structure of the sentence. It tells us about the person saw the specific tiger, the tiger. And when the will be placed in isolation, we are unable to elaborate on what is the meaning of the. We can't tell the specific what is the meaning of the. We can just tell the grammatical function of the. We can tell what are the uses of the, but we are unable to tell the semantic content or meaning of that article the. So remember, the words like auxiliaries like am, is, are, was, were, shall, will, they are unstressed. Then articles like a and the, they are unstressed, they will not receive stress. So that is why they have to be called as weak forms. Then prepositions. There are certain prepositions, no more addition is possible. We cannot add other words and call it as a preposition. So prepositions are unstressed, then conjunctions are unstressed, and pronouns like I, we, he, she, they, you, they are weak. They are not going to receive stress, so they have to be called as weak forms. Not only this, they occur in a sentence only to provide grammatical information. Remember, their objective, their role in a sentence is only to provide grammatical information. So they do not have semantic content. Semantic refers to meaning. Remember, semantic. And syntactic. There are two terms. So semantic refers to meaning and syntactic refers to structure of the sentence. So they play the perform of grammar, they play the role of grammatic, they have the function of grammar. Grammatically they are useful. It certainly plays some function when it is used in a sentence. But when they are separated from the sentence, when it is placed in isolation as independent word, it does not have any meaning. It means it does not have semantic content. So remember, the weak forms are the words which play only grammatical role. It is also called as closed class category of the word, and it comprises articles, prepositions, conjunctions, pronouns and auxiliary verbs. So after that, we have to keep in mind, when the words are shortened or clipped, it will be unstressed. For example, in sentence like, I have done it. So when in a spoken form, this have will be clipped and it will be written as just like this. I have done it. So this, when word is clipped, it will not receive stress. So what is stress? It is also essential or important to understand the meaning of stress. Stress means there are certain words which have monosyllable or polysyllabic words. Words can be either monosyllabic or polysyllabic. So monosyllabic word is a word which contains only one syllable, and the polysyllabic are the words which contains more than one syllable. Now let us discuss. Now look at the word like cat. It is a monosyllabic word, it has just one syllable. But the word like dessert, dessert, it has a two syllable. So it is called as polysyllabic or multisyllabic word. If it has more than two syllable, it will be multisyllabic. Cat is monosyllabic, dessert is polysyllabic. The word like children, child and rain, it is also polysyllabic word, it has a two syllable. So what is stress? It is important to understand each syllable is produced with different level of lung energy. Remember, each syllable is produced with different level of lung energy. So lung energy refers to the air stream that is used at the time of production of sounds. So lung energy means the air stream that is used by human beings to produce sounds. So this lung energy that which comes out of our lungs through the trachea or the windpipe, it does not come regularly as it is. So there can be variation, there can be some intensity can be different, and this intensity, this energy vibrates the vocal cords. Higher the energy, higher the use of airstream, there will be higher pitch, there will be higher vibration. So pitch refers to vibration, and there will be loudness, and there will be intensity of articulation. It means the stress will refer to that the speaker at the time of speaking uses or gives more prominent or importance to particular aspect of that word, particular aspect of the word or particular word of from the sentence, and there will be use of more energy, and such words or such syllables is to be called as stressed syllable. Remember, when there will be the pitch change, when there will be the loudness, there will be the more vibration, and when there will be the more use of energy, that is the wind or the air stream that comes out of our windpipe, is to be considered as stress. So as far as the weak forms are concerned, there will be no stress. The syllable will be unstressed. So certain category of the word, a certain class of the word, like prepositions, articles, then conjunctions, pronouns and auxiliary words, they are unstressed. So for example, if there is a word like is, remember, it will be unstressed, it cannot receive a stress. Then we have to also consider on a concept called schwab. S-C-H-W-A, schwa. So schwa is the syllable or vowel sound which comes at the central position of the monosyllabic word. Remember, words can, as I told earlier, there can be polysyllabic words, there can be monosyllabic word. Monosyllabic refers to the word which has just one syllable, as I talked about the word cat. So it is monosyllabic, and this a comes at the central of monosyllable or single syllabic word. It can be called as monosyllabic or single syllabic. It has just one symbol, one syllable, that is cat. cat, and this schwa, that a, it is always considered as a weak form. It is never going to be strong form. For example, look at the word like but. When it is written in isolation, it will be presented as a strong form. This is the strong form of but. But this schwa, that is a sound, schwa means a sound, which comes in a monosyllabic word, and it comes at the central position, so it will be as but. It will be as but. Same is with the off, it will be as off. So this is schwa. So it is always unstressed. So in monosyllabic word, when monosyllabic words, when consonant comes, when the vowel comes at the central position and it is pronounced as a sound, we call it as schwa, and it is unstressed. So remember which are the words, which are the classes or grammatical functions of the words where the words remain unstressed. So we have to keep in mind auxiliaries, articles, prepositions, conjunctions, pronouns, then schwa and clipped form. Whenever there will be clipped form of the verb, it will not receive stress. So it will be unstressed word. Then contrary to this, there is strong form. So we talked about weak form. Then let us discuss what is strong forms. So strong forms are such type of words, such type of syllables which receive stress. It means that there will be higher energy at the time of uttering particular word or particular syllable. So it is also called as open class category of the word. It means that there are going to be certain words, certain class of grammar, certain things like nouns, adjectives, verbs and adverbs. So these things are called as open class category of the word. So we can add number of nouns, we can add number of verbs. So number of new words, number of new items into vocabulary are added each day or every year into the lexicon of nouns, adjectives, verbs and adverbs. So they will receive stress. Remember, whenever there will be noun in a sentence, it will receive stress. Whenever there will be adjective in a sentence, it will receive stress. Whenever there will be verb in the sentence, it will receive verb in the sense main verb, not auxiliary verb, it will receive stress. And whenever there will be adjective, it will receive a stress. So stress verb or stress form, we have to keep in mind that there will be the more energy, there will be stress will be on syllable, and generally or usually the category of or the class of grammar will be nouns, adjectives, verbs and adverbs. In the next lecture we will see one more important aspect, that is connected speech.